Okay, coming to the quantitative and qualitative dimensions of how we understand them as distinctive from how I would say the economists would use these indices of strikes. Now, in terms of a lot of the kinds of progressive thinking on strikes, the argument really is that significant quantitative increases in strikes would signal qualitative changes in working class consciousness. I know that's a very difficult thing to measure, but I think let's look at how we can look at that more clearly in a concrete level. So normatively, one would talk about F or N for number of strikes or strike frequency, and that's how the Department of Labor uses the word, the concepts, including the International Labor Organization. They will use F for strike frequency, D for days lost, and here they would say days lost to production. And then S would be strikers. And in terms of the way Lenin looked at these things, and I think he was the first really to kind of provide a qualitative label to some of these indices. So he started off with really looking at days lost to production, and there he argued that if you look at days lost to production and the length of time different workers would stay out of work, that would mean that they are very persistent, that there would be the more persistent workers. So whether a worker strikes for a week or 2 weeks or 4 weeks or a month or 3 months, the more they would strike, be on strike, and the more the days lost increase, that would mean that those workers are the most persistent workers. And he used this measure to identify who the vanguard is of the workers' movement in particular, because these workers were the ones who were the most prepared to make sacrifices and challenge the capitalist system. The other indice was strikers, and he argued that, I think including Trotsky, that when there is a significant quantitative change in terms of the mass of workers coming out in strike, that would indicate that there has been a change in consciousness, because what you have now is a situation where at 100% more, 200% more of workers are prepared now to actually embark on strike action, whereas in the last 5 years or 10 years, workers were not willing to come out on strikes. But more closely, if you want to examine the more qualitative aspect of work mobilization using this quantitative indices and then actually studying what is actually happening in those years that you're looking at strikes, the key things that I think resemble a family, and this you can actually use in different periods or even in different periods of history of strikes. And you'll find that the relationship with significant quantitative increase, you will find that there are very significant qualitative changes in the way that there are, for example, changes in strike tactics, whether workers just go on strike as permanent workers, where it's only seasonal workers, or whether they go out as a general strike, or whatever the tactic is that they are using. There are changes in how they could make their struggle, whether at plant level or industry level or regional level or at multi-union level or at federation level. That there are new ideas and policies that workers are demanding, which are distinct from prior years. That strikes are now happening in industries where strikes didn't happen before, or where they did was very, I would say, minuscule. We'll be right back.